And we're just 3 weeks until finals. It's time to start sorting the contenders from the pretenders. The D's and the Blues collide on the road to the Conference B finals. Round six Saturday night action. Melbourne and Carlton from Alice Springs. And the D's will get first use. Hanks puts it into the path of Paxman. She's being pressured by Egan. It gets to the forward 50 for the D's. Egan falls on the football. They wrap her up straight away. And should be penalised. Free kick Melbourne. It's going to go back to Kate Hoare. Hoare delivers the first inside 50 of the evening. Out came Cunningham. That's an outstanding defensive effort. Great contest coming across there by Katie Loynes. Who else?
You expect to see that from Katie Loynes, don't you? She's one of the most courageous players in this competition. Hard as nails, and it's good to see her get to her feet straight away after that heavy hit.
Wonderful mark from the skipper, putting her body on the line in the opening minute. It's going to be a Carlton free kick for holding, going against Cordner. It's coming back to Harris, who's working all the way up to halfback to get an early touch. Harris kicks across the wing. It's punched away from Stevens. Sheriff there. She's harassed and taken down by Edwards. Stevens and Lampard coming over the top.
This is one thing that I'm really enjoying watching from this Carlton forward line, is their ability to work up the ground and then push back, and also that move of Nicola Stevens down, well, up forward, I should say. She's a very steady head, very experienced player, and really sets up a lot for them in attack.
Chance for the D's from the stoppage. Coming out to meet it was McAvoy. Dishes off to Zanka, wants to take on Lelawifi. Little handball inside to Emmonson was good. She'll launch it high inside 50 to a 2-on-2. Cunningham got hands to it, couldn't hang on. At ground level, tries to work Wilson off the line of the football. Taken by Scott. 48 from goal. Touch kick towards the pocket. Punched away by Hosking. Mithen goes at it. Beautiful gather from Hoare. Looks inside. Sweeps a handball. It's nicely read there by Harrington. She pinches it from Scott. Saves the day for the Blues. And Plain will kick it back out to defensive 50. Tough one to control. Beautifully done by Sheriff. She runs to 40 metres. Attacks the goal and just misses to the right-hand side. It's been a bright start by the D's.
He really has. Lots of offensive movement from this D's lineup, and that's what you want to see. We know that they're great defensively, but it's how well that they can make it hit that scoreboard moving forward.
Lelawifi goes to the back pocket, finds arguably the most improved player in the competition, Charlotte Wilson. Her kick to Prespakis, and that's a wonderful contested mark against Hanks. Prespakis will go long down the line. Harris in the middle of that pack, off hands, over and out.
Charlotte Wilson, Jace, she has been brilliant to start this season in 2020. She oozes leadership qualities at just 19 years of age, and what's been so impressive about her is the ability to play on and lock down those dangerous forwards.
Yeah, she's got amazing athletic ability. She's managed to increase her disposals from 3 a game to 12 a game so far this year. Prespakis' kick beats everyone. Here's Harris again working up the ground to perform the link in the chain. Pierce receives the handball. Good tidy delivery up the middle, finds McAvoy. D's want to move it quickly. Handball's a bit high for a Dublin teammate, but she'll get it back from Goldrick. Then runs in a Lelawifi, who stops her cold.
Great stuff, Lindsay. Super stuff.
She'll get the free kick. Special comments boundary side there from Andy Marr. I reckon the Carlton runner. Only 80 family and friends in attendance tonight, so you'll hear plenty from the boundary that you wouldn't normally hear. This is Moody. The switch on from Lelawifi was good. Moody wants to move it quickly. Blues have got some numbers forward of the football. This is the speeds to Dalton. Draws Emmonson. Gives it back to Mahosking. Now Dalton again kept it going. She can cross the 50. We'll look inside towards the top of the goal square, but Melbourne have got numbers back. And that player we spoke about pre-game, Libby Birch, in the right spot.
Mrs. Consistent down there is Libby Birch.
Birch will go towards Zanka, but chopping it off is Sarah Hosking once again. Another having a fantastic season for the Blues. She'll chip it short. Carlton, the number one kick efficiency team in the competition. They do use it so well. This is Georgia G. G, who's kicked 4 goals straight for the season, goes towards Harris. Good effort from Cordner. She's brought to ground. Harris at ground level just crashed through Birch. Look at Harris go. She couldn't quite control it. And in the end, the D's will rush it through. And that's the physical side of Taylor Harris's game that she's really taken up a notch this season.
She really has. And it's the second and third efforts that has everybody so happy with their performance in the first five rounds of 2020. But you touched on it as well, Jace. Their kicking efficiency has gone through the roof from, you know, seasons prior. It's an area that they really have worked on.
This could be a big story. Karen Harrington getting her jaw and cheekbone checked out as the D's move it to the wing. Harrington's had a superb season. She'd be an enormous loss. Georgie Parker will check in on her progress shortly. This is Karen Paxman. First touch for Paxman. She goes short to McAvoy. McAvoy will look back inside to Pierce, who's pushed up to provide some support. Good patient build-up this from the D's. They're using the football superbly. This is Hoare. Hoare steps around the player on the mark, gains some territory, runs to 52 metres, delivers it inside to Newman, and that's an outstanding build-up from Melbourne. Newman maybe just outside her range, was looking to give it off. She's kicked four behinds for the season. There's Karen Harrington. So Alicia Newman for her first goal of the season. From 40 metres out, makes really good contact with that, but it's across the face. Another minor score for the D's.
She didn't look confident at all from the second that ball hit her hand, but she really needs to back herself in. She's got an excellent kick on her. Go back and have a shot.
So Gab Pound will have the kicking in duties as Harrington continues to be assessed on the boundary line. Pound goes to defensive 50. Once again, it's Wilson. That one just off the side of her boot, and that's going to be a Melbourne ball. There's a chance here for the D's. Inside 50s, 3-2 in Melbourne's favour as Pierce again goes short and finds Newman out on the lead. Back to Pierce, who follows up. Runs to 55 from goal. Delivers in the Cunningham direction. Wilson over the top. Hoare front and centre. Slips a tackle. Dodges another. Gives it off. McAvoy tackled by Brazali. Dishes to Sheriff. She gets a look. And misses as well. So some early opportunities for the D's. Unable to hit the target.
They're looking very dangerous early. Very methodical in their build-up to those last inside 50s. So defensively, Carlton just need to tighten up.
Hosking's hit was intended for Pound. It was nicely read by Lampard. The Blues' defensive structure out of position. McAvoy couldn't hold the mark. The dangerous Newman taken down by Prasparkas. Wonderful tackle from Matty Prasparkas, and Newman saw. Play might just be held up momentarily here as they attend to Alicia Newman.
Let's have another look.
Slips the first one and runs in a Prasparkas.
I think it was just impact when she hit the ground there, Jace.
Yeah, she looks a little sick and sorry, doesn't she? She's coming off just to collect herself. So the Blues currently without Harrington. The D's will now be without Newman. It's been a physical contest early, as we expect. Such high stakes for both these teams. Prasparkas goes short, finds Brazali. Blues need a bit of time in possession here. Melbourne have been controlling the football and controlling the territory. Over the back is Downey. Blues have got some numbers. Again, the clean hands of Georgia G, but the handball inside was optimistic. Harris takes out Pierce. Loin, she's wrapped up by Cordner. Down she goes. Pye says free kick Carlton. Loins. Goes towards 50. Vessio tries to work Goldrick under the back, but Birch read it well. Vessio takes her down. Egan. Umpire says lingering tackle, free kick. Going to the D's. And Libby Birch. Darcy Vessio looks nonplussed. Lalawifi attacked it. Coming through was Downey. She can now link up with Lalawifi. Can float a handball over the top. G. Links up with Loins, runs to 55, spears it in low, it'll get over the back. That's a fantastic defensive mark taken by Brianna Tarrant, by Brenna Tarrant rather, and a critical one. Floats the kick to Lampard. Wants to draw the Carlton opponent. Pop a handball over the top to Pierce. Been busy early, her fifth touch. Kicks to a one-on-one, Scott at the back, sockers off the deck, gains a bit of territory up to the wing. Another one-on-one contest. Lane beat Hoare to the football, but turns it over. Chance here for the D's. They've got some numbers forward of the ball. Parry can link up with Kate Hoare. Will grit her teeth and run away from Pound. Has a bounce. Takes on Wilson. Has a second bounce. Runs to 40. A third bounce. Runs to 25. Can chip it over the top to McAvoy. Will it sit? Egan comes to try and shut her down. Hoare keeps going and snaps an unbelievable goal. One of the goals of the year from Kate Hoare. What an effort from Kate Hoare. Starts on the wing. Hard running. Gets it back. Brilliant finish. One of the best goals we've ever seen in AFLW.
Such an incredible athlete is Kate Hoare. Brilliant runner, as we just saw. Takes possession on the wing. Backs herself in to take grass. Sees a teammate inboard and gets it back. Kicks a goal.
Is this the best goal we've ever seen in AFLW?
It would have to be very close, Jace. You can see there, unselfishly, saw her own player in McAvoy inboard and got the handball back, and what a brilliant snap.
Phenomenal finish from the classy Kate Hoare. Kicks her fifth of the season. Zanka got the tap. It went straight to Downey. Can the Blues respond through Egan? She puts it inside 50, off the hands of Pierce. Through the legs of Moody. Here's Harris. Can link up with G. She's a classy finisher. Bends at goalward. It's bouncing to the line. Chance here for Walker and the Blues respond.
Well, it's Georgia G. She's had a sensational start to this game so far. Four disposals. Running at 100%. And she's just got electric leg speed. Very hard to catch, isn't it, Jace?
Walker, Dalton and G, also deadly forward of the football in the front half. And the Blues get the perfect response. Brilliant goal from Kate Hoare. And the ideal response, they say speed kills abs, certainly does in the front half of the Blues.
It was excellent. And Taylor Harris just drawing that defender and releasing that handball at the right split second. And Georgia G, she's so speedy around the ground, incredibly hard to catch.
You're expecting a high quality contest and we're getting one in Alice Springs. Hanks is up and under kick. Loins left it. Hosking, she's tackled off the football. Zanka committing the body. There was Prasparkas on the bottom of that pack. They pile in on top. Ball spills out. And as Katie Loyne said, it's come out. The umpire's paid holding the ball, but the ball's actually out. Diesel get the free kick. And Zanka will launch it long. It'll go towards the back of the contest. Really important hand there from Pound. If that ball got over the back, it was an open goal for the D's. Cunningham ripped it out of the arms of Wilson, but she's immediately tackled.
Cunningham's somebody that, you know, we know how great she is in the air and on ground level, but she hasn't really made a game her own so far in season 2020. So I'm really looking to her to take some strong grabs today and hopefully get some set shots on goal.
Perkins out of the ruck with strength towards the top of the square. Dangerous position here. Beautiful smother off the boot of Parry. And Wilson gets it to Prasparkas, but her kick will come straight back. It's marked by Sheriff. She looks inboard over the head of Stevens. It was a beautifully weighted kick to Perkins. Sarah Perkins well within range, 35 out.
Yeah, she has this distance covered, Jace. It's an excellent story. We saw her get another opportunity with this side last week against West Coast down at Casey Fields. She kicked a goal after the siren and celebrated truly, as we expect from Sarah Perkins. So it would be a nice start for her to get one early.
So chance for the D's to get their second. Perkins stutter step 40 metres out, makes good contacts. Never looked like missing.
It's good for Perko's confidence levels to get ball in hand early and get a set shot on goal and put it through truly. She really is, you know, a confidence player, and if she's up and about early, it's going to be, you know, really difficult for Carlton defenders to shut her down.
See the size advantage she has there on Nat Plain. So a real mismatch opportunity with Harrington, of course, on the bench. There's Karen Harrington. So the Blues down a key defender. So Abs with the Blues down a key defendant, Karen Harrington. Nat Plain has got the job on Sarah Perkins, and well, there's a fair size difference between the pair.
Yeah, a bit of a mismatch there, but Sarah Perkins, it's great for her. You know, she comes into this Melbourne Demon side as an injury replacement player and is now getting her opportunity to star at AFLW level.
Moody links up with Egan. Egan runs into some traffic and is taken down. Ball spills out. Spinning through was Paxman, ran into Edwards. Zanka now tries to control it. She runs into Prasparkas, who takes her down. Ricochets off Moody. Hanks was clean. Got it to Paxman. Bends a kick towards half forward. Coming out to attack it was Mith and did well against Stevens. Chance here for the Ds to 50. Lalawifi, the good rundown tackle from behind.
With Lauren Pearce out of this side with, you know, knee injury problems, Eden Zanker's just providing that another level, I guess, of athleticism around the ground, which is good to see.
Paxman to Sheriff. Sheriff goes inside 50. Hall run down. Good tackle from Plain. Got the handball free. They pile in on top. It spills to Mith, and great tackle from Stevens. Buries her into the turf. Lily Mith in second game back after ankle surgery in the preseason. Zanker tried to get it to Paxman. Gay can't quite slap it clear. Egan has it pinched. Here's Paxman from 48 metres out. Goes towards Perkins. Really important hand in there from Lalawifi. Takes Perkins out. Umpire says play on. Plain to Stevens. High ball out towards defensive 50. And that's a really good, strong mark taken by Sheriff. Such an impressive youngster in her second season of AFLW, the 21-year-old. Sheriff delivers inside 50. Off the hands of Plain and Egan. Gay runs into Hanks. Gives it off to Parry. Floats it towards the square. Cunningham couldn't control it. Front and centre is Hanks. Dragged off her kick at just the right moment. And it's out of bounds on the fall. A goal-saving tackle there on Tyler Hanks. Some scrambling defence here from the Blues. They've been under pressure. Wilson's kick to Prasparkas. Couldn't control it. Vesio at ground level. Prasparkas as well. Lampard falls across. Hosking. Quick kick out of the pack. It's all Melbourne. A fumble from Zanka. Steps around Egan. High ball inside 50. Bouncing football. Plain will get there first. Tries to step inside Mithen. Looks for an option. McAvoy drops the mark. Now she's under pressure. It'll spill in the Zanka direction. She slaps it to Emmonson. Great body work from Vesio. Gets it to Prasparkas. Prasparkas to a one-on-one off the hands of Harris. She'll try to keep it alive. It's got a couple of metres on Scott. Ducks under the tackle. Shelley comes back for more. Taylor sees her off. We'll kick it inside 50, but once again, Libby Birch in the best position to take the intercept grab.
It was brilliant work there by Harris. Just a shimmy and shake and get out of that Melbourne tackle. But unfortunately, none of her teammates had pushed forward hard enough to really provide that option.
Mithen a critical mark and then turns it over. And surely that wasn't the required distance, but the mark taken by Downey.
She just needs to hold it up here and let her players get back and set up.
25 seconds. There's a whistle off the ball. Have to wait on this. It's going to come back.
No.
And it's going to be a Melbourne free kick.
Yeah, so that was Taylor Harris on Harriet Cordner. Yeah, off the ball, just to that right-hand side of screen.
So the Blues denied one last scoring opportunity in the opening term. The Ds have it. Kate Hoare just backward of the wing. She floats a kick towards half-forward. Zanka in the air against Moody. Too strong for Pound at ground level. Paxman to Gay. 2 seconds remaining as she goes the spiral inside 50. Entertaining opening term. Karen Harrington back on the field is the good news for the Blues. And at quarter time in Alice Springs, it's Melbourne 2-3-15, Carlton 1-1-7 on Saturday Night Footy.